It has always intrigued me when researching the Quran as to why the surahs, chapters, are not in their order of alleged revelation, and moreover, why there are ayat, verses, from the Medina period embedded into the Meccan ones and vice versa. What's your input?
As our series expands, we shall dwell upon every single characteristics of Muhammad and his Quran. Each and every one of them will be investigated, and we shall bring them to the attention of our audience. We shall do so based, as usual, entirely upon the Muhammadan records themselves, that never fail to prove the opposite of what the scholars of Muhammadan Islam do their best to deceive both the believers and the unbelievers. Contrary to the current falsified assertions by the learned followers of Muhammad, the Islamic records show that according to the opinion of the majority of the earliest Muhammadan exegetes, the surahs of the Quran were not arranged by Muhammad, and that the whole sequence is based on ijtihad. Ijtihad is the technical term of Islamic law that describes the process of making a legal decision by independent interpretation of the legal sources, the Quran and the Sunnah. The reason for this conclusion is based upon the fact that there are important and undeniable differences in the sequences of the codices of the companions that we have available. The following are the orders of three important masahif, books, as mentioned by Imam Jalaluddin al-Suyuti and Abu al-Faraj Muhammad ibn Ishaq al-Waraq, also known as Ibn Nazm. I shall only recite the first 12 out of 114 surahs from each, and those listeners who want more detail should go to our website of www.inthenameofallah.org. Order of Ibn Mas'ud's Codex 2, 4, 3, 7, 6, 5, 10, 9, 16, 11, 12, and 18. Order of Ubay's Codex 1, 2, 4, 3, 6, 5, 10, 8, 9, 11, 19, and 26. Order of Ibn Abbas's Codex 96, 68, 93, 73, 74, 1, 111, 81, 87, 92, 89, and 94. All of the above sequences are, of course, different from the current Quran, which are 5, 87, 89, 92, 112, 55, 39, 88, 113, 51, 52, 53. Ahmad bin Faris said, "There were two aspects to the compilation of the Quran. One was putting the surahs in a certain order, such as putting as-sab' al-tiwal, the seven long surahs, first, and following them with the ma'in, which is what the Sahaba, Muhammad's companions, did. The second aspect is the compilation of the ayat within the surahs. This was instituted by the Prophet, who recited them as he was told by Jibreel on the command of his Lord. On this basis, the Salaf differed as to the order in which the surahs should appear. Some of them put them in the order of revelation, which was the Mus'haf of Ali, which started with Iqra al-Alaq, 96, then al-Mudathir, 74, then al-Qalam, 68, then al-Muzammil, 73, and so on. The Mus'haf of Ibn Mas'ud started with al-Baqarah, 2, then al-Nisa, 4, then al-Imran, 3, with other major differences. The Mus'haf of Ubay was similar. Even the sequences of the Quranic revelations are totally incompatible with each other in the codices of Muhammad's companions, unlike the revelations of the Bible, which are orderly, sequential, and without variations. Believers and unbelievers, in the 1970s, 30 years ago, archaeologists discovered a trove of manuscripts, masahif of the Quran, dating as far back as the first century of Hijra, 7th century AD. The first tentative conclusions, published recently by researchers with access to the Yemeni Masahif, reveal that in several cases, the organization of the text is different. The surahs, chapters, sometimes in a different order, as well as there are differences in the text itself. Because the published findings are few at the moment, One cannot tell how wide the divergence is from the current text. The greatest tragedy of finds like these in Muhammadan Muslim countries is the fact that the Muhammadan religious authorities will physically destroy and eradicate any and all documentary evidence that would contradict the present format of the Quran so as to preserve the myth that the Quran that we have today is the same as that passed on by Muhammad to his followers 1400 years ago. The version of the Quran that we have today was codified under the rulership of Uthman bin Affan, the third Khalifa, after having destroyed six others that were written by some of the closest and most learned companions of Muhammad. This act speaks volumes about the sanctity and holiness of Allah's book if a mere mortal can have his words burnt into oblivion. We are informed by other scholars of Muhammad and Islam that the Osmanic arrangement was such that the surahs with the greatest number of verses, ayat, were put at the beginning, followed by descending order with all the others. Their explanation is completely wiped out by the fact that the first surah, Al-Fatiha, is with 7 verses, followed by Al-Baqarah with 286 verses, then by Al-Imran, 200 verses, Al-Nisa, 176 verses, Al-Ma'idah, 120 verses, Al-An'am, 165 verses, and Al-A'raf, 206 verses. The system utterly breaks down within the first 7 surahs or chapters. All their attempts to give this man-made arrangement divine or mystical attributes collapses when put under the scrutiny of facts, recorded history, and logic. As we have shown in numerous other chapters of this series, there is absolutely nothing divine about a book that was completely and unilaterally authored by one human being called Muhammad.